therapist, AOMPT, after seeing the response from the participants and also the enthusiasm and the passion to teach, especially by Ms. Sahana, it's a great virtue now to have for all of us in the eve of Navaratri. And then I thought that we'll keep a series of yoga webinars to celebrate this eve by making all the girls to attend yoga. The main the thought, which is unintentional, is I always believe men, if they have to rule the world, okay, they have to conquer others, okay, they have to beat others, they have to be victorious over others. But whenever I see women, if they have to rule the world, they should conquer themselves. Okay, so a woman who has conquered her own self, who has won over her own emotions, her own strengths and weaknesses, she knows, she is the one, automatically she need not attack anyone, others will come and surrender in front of her foot. So that way, women empowerment begins with the self enlightenment. And what better than yoga, and what better than Ms. Sahana teaching us? Okay, so it's always a pleasure to again welcome her for the third webinar. It's a hat trick webinar. Okay, so it's three webinars in 3 days, and it's not just she's launching. Okay, she's taking online, and then she's taking group sessions like this for the first time in her life. But she's a great blessing to all of us. So I wish Sahana the best of luck to take today mainly the therapeutic yoga for weight reduction. Mainly, she might concentrate more on areas where fat acquisition is there, and to concentrate from women's health perspective, okay, in women, the weight reduction and how we can go ahead with the yoga. So over to Ms. Sahana, take over, please.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Sahana. Today's section about weight reduction. Mainly, weight can be fat can be accumulated for various reasons. That may be due to stress and improper lifestyle and all. We can kind of get over from. Is it audible?
Yes, audible. Perfect.
Yes, sir.
Any participants, if you have any problems, just text on the chat, okay, so that I can see, everyone can see, okay,
yes.
And then I can alert madam. It's fine.
Yoga is a better way to for weight reduction. Let us start the session by chanting a prayer, sitting samasthiti. Exhaling, fold your left leg. Inhale. Exhaling, fold your right leg and keep the foot in between two calves of left leg. Do namaste. Palms should be in front of chest. Close your eyes. You can follow. Yogena chittasya padena vacham malam sharirasya cha vaidyakena yopakarottam pravaram muninam patanjalim pranjali ranatosmi om shanti 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 hi. inhaling, unfold your right leg. Exhale. Inhaling, unfold your left leg. Now stand up. Do not force yourself while attempting the final posture. Do rhythmic breathing. Let us start by warm up. Arm rotations. In reverse manner. Neck exercises. Inhaling, raise your neck. Exhaling, down. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now do it sideways. Do not move your body, only neck. Now sideways. Now shoulder rotation. Keep your fingers on the top of shoulder. Do it in a reverse way. Now, keep your legs apart. Take both arms in front. Now move your waist. Now, keep both the palms on your waist and move sideways. please. Join both the legs. Keep both the palms on knee joints, respective knee joints. Knee rotation. In the reverse way. Now, foot, right foot, in reverse way. Left foot, reverse way, yes. Now keep both the legs apart. Inhaling, raise your arms. Join both the palms. Exhaling, come down. Squat position. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling, come down. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling, come down. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling.
Miss Sahana. I think the device got muted. Can you unmute?
Yes.
Admin cannot unmute. Zoom always has disabled that admin unmuting. Okay. It is okay, like sir. I can only ask the member to unmute. Okay. I cannot unmute anyone. Okay. So, okay. Where is Sana? Yeah.
Is audible now, sir? Yeah. Properly.
Oh, now it is audible. Yes.
Now, standing samasthiti.
Yes, audible, audible.
Join both the legs. Inhaling. Raise your arms and join the palms. Exhaling, bend forward. Touch both the palms to the ground. Inhaling, look up. Exhaling, jump slowly. If you can't jump, keep one leg. Inhaling, raise your chest up to navel area. Exhaling, raise your torso. Look at the navel region and do 5 breathings. Inhaling, jump. Forward. Look up. Exhaling, try to touch your forehead to the knee joint. Inhaling, slowly come up. Exhaling, release. One more time. Inhaling, join your palms. Exhaling, bend forward slowly. Do not bend your knee joints. Legs should be straight. Inhaling, look up. Exhaling, jump. Do not touch your body to the ground. Inhaling, raise your chest, abdomen. Exhaling, raise your hips. Look at the navel region and do 5 breathings. Inhaling, jump forward. Exhaling. Try to touch your forehead to the knee joint. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling, release. One more time. Inhaling, join your palms. Exhaling, bend forward. Inhaling, look up. If you can't jump, you can keep legs one by one. Then Dandasana. Keep palms and only feet on the ground. Look forward. inhaling, raise your body. Now exhaling, raise your hips. Look at the navel region. And do 5 breathings. Inhaling, jump or keep legs. If you can jump, directly jump. Exhaling, try to touch your forehead to the knee joint. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling, release. Now, Tadasana 1, standing Samasthiti, keep your body weight equally on both the feet, stand erectly, look straight forward, inhaling raise your arms and join your palms, slowly, look up, and do 5 breathings. Exhaling, release slowly. Now, inhaling, one more time, raise your arms slowly, look up, and do 5 breathings. Exhaling, slowly release. Now, Tadasana 2. Inhaling, raise your arms slowly. Look up. Exhaling, bend forward. Try to keep both the palms on the ground. Contract your abdominal area. Close your eyes and do 5 breathings. Inhaling, slowly come up. Exhaling, release. Inhaling, raise your arms sideways. Exhaling, bend forward slowly. Inhaling, come up, look up, join your palms, exhaling, release. Now, Padangusthasana. Inhale. Exhaling. Keep your legs apart. Do not widen too much. Exhaling. Respective big toes. Exhaling, bend. Close your eyes and do breathing. Inhale fully and exhale completely. Inhaling, come up. Release your hands. Inhale. Exhaling, bend. Bend from your tailbone, not bend directly from my ear. That may restrict the bending movements. Inhale. Exhaling, bend. And hold your respective big toes. Inhale, exhaling, drop your neck. Close your eyes and do breathings. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling, release. Now, join your legs. Inhaling, keep your right leg towards right side. One leg distance. Raise your arms up to shoulder level. This is Virabhadrasana. Exhaling, turn your right foot on your right side. Inhale. Exhaling, bend your right leg. Thigh should be perpendicular to the ground. This should be 90 degree angle. Look at the tip of right hand and do 5 breathings. Inhaling, come up. Exhale. Inhaling, turn your foot in front. Exhaling, turn your left foot towards left side. Exhaling, bend. look at the tip of left hand and do 5 breathings. Inhaling, come up. Exhale, inhaling, turn your foot in front. Inhale. Exhaling, turn your right foot on your right side. Exhaling, bend. And keep your right palm on right side of your right foot. This is Parshvakonasana. Look at the tip of left hand and do 5 breathings. Arm should be over your left ear. Inhaling, come up. Exhale, inhaling, turn your foot in front. Inhale, exhaling, turn your left foot on left side. Exhaling, bend and take your right arm over your right ear. Look at the tip of right hand and do breathings. Inhaling, come up. Exhale. Inhaling, turn your foot. Now, Trikonasana. Inhale. Exhaling, turn your right foot on the right side. Exhaling, bend laterally. Hold your right big toe. Look at the tip of left hand and do breathing slowly. Never do it rapidly. Do not tighten your body parts. If you can't hold, try to touch the leg. If you can't balance. If you have a good flexibility, then you can hold your big toe. Inhaling, come up. Exhale. Inhaling, turn your foot in front. Exhaling, turn your left foot on your left side. Inhale, exhaling, slowly bend laterally. Look at the tip of right hand and do breathings. Inhaling, come up. Exhale. Inhaling, turn your foot in front. Now, Parivrutta Trikonasana. Inhale. Exhaling, turn your right foot on your right side. Inhale. Exhaling. Turn your body. And keep left palm on right side of your right foot. And look at the tip of hand and do breathings. If you can't touch your palm to the ground, try to hold your ankle. If you can touch, it is good. Inhaling, come up. Exhale. Inhaling, turn your foot in front. Inhale. Exhaling, turn your left foot on your left side. Exhaling, turn your body. And keep your right palm on left side of your left foot. Look at the tip of left hand. Inhaling, come up. Exhale. Inhaling, turn your foot in front. Exhaling, join both the legs. Now sit. Widen your legs and relax. Do deep inhalation and exhalations. Keep your palms behind, backward. Do deep inhalation and exhalation. Now sit in Samasthiti. Join your foot. Keep both the palms beside. Inhale. Exhaling, fold your right leg and keep it on left thigh. Padmasana. Inhale. Exhaling, bend your left leg and keep it on a right thigh. Keep both the hands in Chin Mudra. Press your index and thumb finger. Feel the pulse. Do not press. Just feel the pulse. Keep it on respective knee joints. Close your eyes. Keep back, neck and head erect. And do breathings. slowly open your eyes. Release hands from chin mudra. Keep both the hands backward or fold. Fold it from the back. Now inhale deeply and exhaling, bend forward. Try to touch your forehead to the ground. Inhaling, come up. Inhaling, slowly come up. Exhaling, release your hands. Inhaling, stretch your left leg. Exhale. Inhaling, stretch your right leg. Now sit in Samasthiti. Inhaling. Turn your both the legs backward and sit on the heels. Vajrasana. Keep both the palms on thighs. Look straight forward and do breathings. Now, release, hold respective big toes by your hands. Inhale, do not overlap your big toes on one another. Keep them separate. Inhale deeply, exhaling. Bend forward slowly. Try to touch forehead to the ground. Inhaling, come up. Exhaling, release. Now, Gomukhasana. Inhale. Exhaling, take both arms backward and try to hold your hands. Look straight forward and do breathings. Inhaling, release and do it on other side. Exhaling, hold your hands. Look straight forward. Inhale, release. Slowly inhaling, turn your foot in front. Now, Ardha Matsyendrasana. Keep your left leg below the right thigh. Inhaling, fold your right leg and keep it on left side of your left leg. Keep your back straight. Exhaling, hold your right big toe or at least try to keep it on your left knee joint. And turn your torso. Look backward. Inhaling, slowly turn in front. Inhaling, stretch your leg, right leg. Inhaling, stretch your left leg. Now, exhaling, keep your right leg below left thigh. Exhaling, bend your left leg. And keep it on right side of your right thigh. Keep your back straight. Right hand. Yes. Look backward and do breathings. Inhaling, come. Inhaling, stretch your left leg. Exhale. Inhaling, stretch your right leg. Now, Pavana Muktasana. Lay on your back. Inhaling, fold your right leg. Fold your right leg. Exhale. Inhaling, raise your neck. Close your eyes and do 5 breathings. Exhaling, release your neck, inhale, exhaling, stretch your right leg, inhaling, bend your left leg, fold your arms, inhaling, raise your neck. Close your eyes, contract your abdominal area, and do 5 breathings. Exhaling, release your neck. Inhale, exhaling, stretch your leg. Inhaling, fold your both legs simultaneously. Fold both the arms. Inhaling, raise your neck. Exhaling, release neck, release your neck, keep it on the floor, inhale, exhaling, stretch your both the legs, Now, inhaling, raise your right leg, only right leg. And hold your right big toe. If you can't hold, keep it perpendicular to the ground. And you can keep your hand erect. If you can hold, hold. Look upward and do 5 breathings. really, really inhaling, raise your left leg and hold your left big toe by left hand. Look upward and do 5 breathings. Exhaling, release. Now, Sarvangasana, keep both the palms below your thigh. Inhaling, raise your leg. Support your back. Close your eyes and do breathing. Exhaling, bend your leg. Try to touch your legs to the ground. Try to touch your toes to the ground. Extend your arms in front. This is Halasana. Inhaling, come up. Slowly release. Inhaling, slowly get up. Swastikasana. Exhaling, fold your left leg. Inhale, exhaling, fold your right leg and keep it in between the calves. Keep left hand in Chin Mudra, right hand in Mrigi Mudra. Mrigi Mudra. Hold your index and middle finger. Hold. Yes. Take it in front of the face. Anuloma Vinuloma. Anuloma Viloma Pranayama. Inhale through the left nostril and exhaling it through the right nostril. Again inhaling it through the right and exhaling it through the left nostril. Close your eyes. Inhale. Inhale. Exhale. Exhalation should be double of your inhalation. exhaling it through the left nostril. Release your hands. Keep both hands in chin mudra. Close your eyes and chant Omkara. Close your eyes. Om. Do not open your eyes. Do not open. Release chin mudra. Inhaling, stretch your right leg. Exhale. Inhaling, stretch your left leg. And shavasana. Lie on your back. Close your eyes. Keep right palm on the abdomen and left palm on the chest. Widen your legs by making 30 degree angle. Do not tighten your body parts. Inhale deeply and exhale completely. Thank you. Stretch your arms. Close your both the legs. Slowly open your eyes and observe the surrounding environment. Rub your both the palms. Turn to your right side and get up. Turn to your right side. Yes. You can extend the timing of each asana. Because of the shortage of time, I'm reducing it. Is it audible?
Yeah, it's audible. Can you show some of the modifications? Like somebody who is obese, okay? They are having a lot of restrictions. They cannot do. Then how all these main asanas which are involving the abdomen, how all they can modify? Standing one, bending, we can touch the thigh. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
If they are not able to touch the floor.
At least attempting the enough, sir. And some twisting asanas like Ardha Matsyendra asana and all, that helps to reduce the accumulated fat here, sir, sideways. This one. Just attempting also helps. This one, sir. And Paschimottanasana. This. And while bending itself, contracting the abdominal area is important. Contracting abdominal area burns the fat. And again, after doing this upward plank, it also helps.
These and all may be difficult. This is actually more difficult.
Yeah, okay, sir. But this is counter asana to the Paschimottanasana. After doing this, one must do this one. That is more beneficial. And Kapalabhati helps more.
For example, with the knee straight, it is not possible. Can we keep the knee bent?
No, sir. Keep both the knees straight. At least do this much.
No, not contact this. The other one. That lifting the back. The previous one.
They can. At least is this much, sir. While inhaling, raising the body is enough. Inhaling. And this one also helps, sir. Full plank.
That plank what you showed. This plank also. Yes. If it is difficult, they can keep a little bit support there for the leg.
Sir. They can take support. And the Agnisara also helps. Agnisara Kriyas. In empty stomach itself, when have to do that?
What is that?
Agnisara means.
What is that Agnisara Kriya?
It is Shat Kriyas.
No, what do you actually do in that?
In that, sir, one have to stand straightly and then bending and contracting the abdominal area. Again standing.
Okay.
Again doing. Until and unless they feel sweat, they have to do that again and again. That Agnisara is very beneficial in obese conditions. And Sarvangasana also helps. They can take wall or chair. That reduces the load over digestive system and reduces fat. Helps to burn fat, accumulated fat.
Any suggestion for diet?
Diet, sir, yes, sir. Avoiding the which street food and all is good, and the fiber rich food, intake of fiber rich food is more essential. For example, drumstick or lady's finger, beans, and all. Raw vegetables, intake of raw vegetables also very good.
And timing with asana and the food?
The after taking meals, sir, there should be a gap of 3 hours. If it is of light meal like snacks and all, 1 hour is enough.
Snacks means like water.
Water?
Natural snacks. What are the snacks?
Snacks means like tea, coffee, and snacks means what?
Tea, coffee, we can take.
What?
Tea, coffee, we can take.
Tea, coffee, after taking of tea, coffee, 15 to 20 minutes gap. Because in bending asanas also, that may interrupt the posture and procedure of doing asanas.
And after asana, immediately we can take food?
No, sir. No, never. There should
be a gap. Should be there.
You should not take a bath immediately.
You should not take bath immediately.
Not immediately, sir. Because one have to start after taking the bath asanas. That is
okay,
very
good.
Okay.
So, participants who have queries, you can put on the chat or you can raise your hand. Then I can unmute. You can ask. Anjana was there already, always on the screen. She was doing very sincerely. Anjana? Yes. Wait, I'll unmute you. You can unmute and then you can speak. Anjana, you come and unmute yourself. I have enabled that for you. You unmute and then you can talk. Oh, there is another person for you. Okay. Wait. Again, you are muted. Unmute. Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Anjana. Speak.
Actually, I'm not Anjana. My name is Archana.
Your name is Archana?
Yeah. Archana.
Anyway, certificate will come as Anjana only. Because in the phone, you have kept that Anjana name only. You ask your queries and you share your experience. You are doing the asanas with madam, na?
Your voice is not clear, ma'am.
And that is mainly because of the connectivity. The internet connectivity. That creates that voice to be getting scattered, okay? Especially when video is streaming. And if it is not 4G, that much level is not there. Now in Bangalore, it is raining. Okay, so it started fluctuating, the connectivity in between. Because they have to promote the 5G, they have made the 4G to be pathetic. Okay, so these things are happening now.
Here also raining.
Yes.
They're also raining. Very good. There it has to rain. Because in old Proverbs, it is there. Wherever good people are there, it has to rain. Okay. What, Preetha ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. The section was very good. I learned my note.
Thank you, ma'am.
मुझे कुछ रेड रेड आई वाज जस्ट सेइंग दैट यू आर सेइंग दैट वी आर गुड पीपल इफ देयर रेन कम्स सो इट मींस वी आर बैड पीपल इन आवर एरिया देयर इज नो रेन फ्रॉम लास्ट 2 months
वेयर आवर ग्रेट पीपल आर देयर सनलाइट कम्स ओके
गुड गुड गुड
बिकॉज़ सनलाइट इज द सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी
Very okay. nice session, ma'am. Very good exercises.
Thank you.
Really, very nice. That's why we are here from last 3 days. We are continuing joining your sessions. This is really very helpful for weight reduction. Some asanas are very difficult for me. I was not able to do that, but I will definitely try regularly. That Gomukha asana was.
Regular, doing it regularly improves flexibility, sir, ma'am.
Gomukha asana was little bit difficult because the both hands were.
Yes, it is difficult. At least try to hold. Like
yeah, this. I was trying, ma'am. I was trying, but not keeping touch in my both hands. But I will try definitely daily. I will try. Thank you, yes. ma'am. Thank you so much for a wonderful session.
Thank you, ma'am, for cooperation and all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks to you, ma'am. You are
because Rita, are... ma'am, is also. One person who can always, she is always on the screen. Okay, she is also doing. Dr. Ashwini has a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Dr. Ashwini.
Hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. I have a question.
All India Radio and all. You have to come on the screen.
Sir, my video, I have problem in my video actually. It's not coming. It's showing blackout. That's the reason.
During the difficult asanas, okay, when the difficult asanas were coming, my video also some technical trouble was there.
No. I'll show my video, see. My video is on only, see.
I think it is the camera.
It's dark.
Camera problem.
No, some issue with
camera.
My That's why.
Yeah, it looks like a horror movie. Okay.
That's why
so
I didn't know.
You can talk video muted. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, it is audible. Yeah. You can ask
them. Actually, this is yoga for obesity management, right? Weight loss for. So, I have other question which is not involved here. The thing is regarding H-shaped walking, infinity walking.
Okay.
Infinity walking for weight loss.
Weight loss.
No. That yeah. is actually out of context. Okay. See, it's a different schools of thought. Okay. What people practice for weight loss. It is not related to the asana or the kriyas of yoga. Okay. So.
But usually in yoga only they used to teach different types of walking. One of that will be the infinity walking, that is H-shaped walking, which was followed by our, by Gurujis and all. So,
see,
just wanted
today
to
they are clear. Gurujis, tomorrow they'll be the jail. Okay. So don't be going with the Gurujis. And everybody wants to individualize the yoga, okay, according to their ashram and their school of thought. So they will add some things. Different Gurujis have different target population. Okay. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar targets the educated group, the younger college group. Ramdev Baba targets the people who are community level at villages. Okay. So there are a lot of people teaching a lot of things in order to reach the population. okay? So there are different variations of things, and they keep new names so that people are actually what they stick to that regime and the program, okay? If it is same, what will happen? The population will think that other Guruji and this Guruji is the same, okay? So it will not help in their marketing strategy. So that is the reason why they do all those things, okay? If you go back to original literature of Ashtanga Yoga, okay, and then you see the content, which are the ones which are there, there's nothing that is mentioned like this different types of walking and all, okay? So don't go by what is told. In fact, even Ms. Sahana can highlight much better, but this is my perspective because I have a more of a common sense, okay? I keep talking to common man, okay? I keep listening
because,
to a lot of
the thing so is many say
Anna ma'am, can you highlight on this?
Sir?
Yes. Can you add on this point? Your opinion on this different types of walking and all for weight loss.
Walking and all it is eliminating or getting up from the sedentary lifestyle is very important in reducing weight, ma'am. Not only.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say is, as part of physical therapy, it is there. Okay, physical activity, prescription, walking.
Yes.
But in yoga, do we have the different types of walking or infinity walking like that?
Yes, sir.
Do we have anything called as infinity walking?
No, sir.
In yoga.
I'm here. Hearing this word first time, sir. I'm not
exactly.
Much
even I know that these are publicized in Osho groups, okay, where the international target is there, okay, population. So
yes.
See, this is the thing that happens nowadays. Everybody is yoga instructor, okay. They get a certificate. After that, they can teach anything. Nobody knows what they are teaching, okay. Nobody verifies with the original content, okay. And then if Guruji is 50 plus, we think that whatever they tell is correct, okay? And if some 10 foreigners are sitting, then they are global expert, okay? So that is the thing that happens, which I wanted to highlight to that participant also. So everybody, actually, it's a good query that everybody, you should know, you know, the channel, okay? What you are actually going when you are getting trained. Okay. And today, to highlight the fact that we have participants from Pakistan, we have participants from Malaysia, okay? We have participants also from Bangladesh, okay? And one more country. Okay? So, these are like very... Like we can see with my screen, Dr. Mariam, who's there, she's from Egypt, okay? So there are a lot of people, oh yeah, Egypt, okay? So various countries, okay? So yoga is beyond religions, okay? There are people from different streams.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And
in this condition, it is not only one day practice. You have to practice regularly and rhythmically. Up to like in morning, it is early morning, it is a best time, just before 9 a.m. If you practice for 1 to 1.5 hour in the beginning section, it is very beneficial. With the proper diet,
right,
and you can have, then it may take up to 3 months to regularize your BMI level.
No, even
and
if...
at that simultaneously you have to reduce your stress. That stress may also put on your weight. In this condition, meditation, anuloma viloma pranayama and padmasana are very good for stress. These are stress eliminating practices.
I think when that initial 1 to 2 weeks, that discomfort will go, okay, that body.
It,
then after that,
in initial condition, sir, eliminating air from the body is very important. Do Pavana Muktasana for longer period of time. That eliminates the air. That improves the flexibility and bending. That aids the yogic practices.
Any other special diet for that elimination of gas or air?
Gas means in Hatha Yoga Pradipika, it says moderate diet, mitahara. That rice, ghee and combination of rice, ghee and milk is very good.
So ghee is no problem.
Ghee means, sir, this is good for yogic practices, sir. And you can eat cucumber and all. Those are high fiber, good fiber content.
Water.
That helps to reduce weight.
Cucumber like a half an hour before food.
Yes, sir. Vegetable salad and pulse salad, it's good, sir. And divide your meals. Instead of taking three main meals, divide your meals of five. Like same amount, eat it five times. Like having a breakfast like 9 a.m. and again taking brunch at 12 a.m. Having lunch at 2 p.m. It helps to reduce weight.
Okay, so we have exceeded the time beyond the schedule.
Yes,
so we are
sir.
Ready now to close the session for today. And
yes.
We are looking forward to the next session on polycystic ovary syndrome.
Okay.
Okay, for the women. And then we'll see whether menopause or after menopause, we need another session like that. So we'll see.
Okay.
It may not be tomorrow. Okay, I'll just inform the schedule. Okay, I'll tell you. It must be day after or it is Saturday. Okay, so we'll see that. Clear? So we'll be seeing Ms. Anna again. And when we see the 3 days itself, okay, when we see there are participants who are doing for the 3 days, they will feel that more comfortness, okay, more they are better to do. And that's why this whole week is like we are distributed with yoga's sessions. Tomorrow we have a different session. Okay. So that's why this yoga session won't come the same 7 p.m. Okay. So that is the reason. So we will go ahead with more and more topics which will benefit the women. I was telling you for the Dasara. Okay. So women's health, that is the focus this week. And wish Ms. Segana the best of luck to keep inspiring and keep motivating everyone to be healthy in the body, mind, and also in the soul. So the enlightenment and the experience of inner self, okay, the inner awareness through this practice of yoga. So we are ready to